Hi, like Karen said, I'm Nic Frick. Welcome. I'm breathing all of you in so that we can all be feel connected right now. And if you're joining this session for the first session today, welcome. I'm Nic Frick, as I said. If you've been here since this morning, welcome and thank you for being here. And if you've been here since this morning, please grab your lunch, go get something to eat, get some tea, bring me in your headphones and I'll see you in the back. I'll see you when you get back, rather. What you are about to experience is the result of the last 12 years I've spent working in customer service, as a yoga instructor, in tech recruiting, and career coaching. Over my lifetime, I've worked with life coaches, career coaches, and everyone in between to gather the tools and insights I've created to create my own career path that has blown me away with things I never would have imagined. Specifically, like this summit, one of the things I love doing, even though I'm very nervous sometimes about it, let me step back for a second. One of the things we're going to cover today is our inner critic or imposter syndrome. And in that, I got to experience that before I stepped on stage today. And I am reminded how powerful our thoughts are, how powerful imposter syndrome is. And I want to share with you tools how to guide you through your career planning so it always feels aligned, it feels confident, and it feels like you have a clear, natural next step. For me, the summit, I know for myself, and you probably know for yourself, it may not be the same issue or self-awareness, but I know that as soon as I step on stage, this stage, as you can see, I become the best me available. But until then, my masculine takes over, my thoughts take over. And I get to be on stage with you today, as I love workshops. And so I'm so glad to be here with you today. The biggest change in my career that has happened most recently is in 2019, I had my daughter, and I had been working in tech and customer service for 10 years. And as soon as my daughter was born, my values completely shifted. And it became so important to me that I was only spending time doing things outside of seeing her that were very, very important to me. And so when I was about to return to work, my husband asked me, what do you want to do? Like, how do you want to do? And I started looking for recruiting jobs. I started looking for sales jobs. I started looking for customer success jobs, because in recruiting, those skills are all kind of transferable. And I kept saying, oh, it's really easy for me to find a job. I'll just find a job. And he was like, no, what do you actually want to be doing? And I sat with it, because it's also one of the important questions I asked my clients, because sometimes we're so afraid of taking a leap that we don't even know what the answer is. But I've known the answer since college. Excuse me. I've always wanted to be a coach. And my daughter caused the catalyst to do that today. And so my husband said, please coach so that we don't have to have the same effing conversation again in 2 years. And so now I get to help women, especially new moms, confidently find the career path they crave so that they can add more joy and freedom in their lives. And I do this, through group and private coaching. I guide and support my clients to feeling stuck, dreading work, and overwhelmed, to having the confidence to ask for what they want, both at home and at work. I want to tell you something that happened to me when I woke up this morning. I've been working on this workshop for probably for actively 2 weeks, mentally 4 weeks, 5 weeks. And not until this morning, I had a very different talk with you today. I had a very different talk prepared for you today. And then I woke up and was like, your talk is too masculine. Your talk is too not connected to you. And it's like what you're supposed to do. And so I stripped the slides. You can see I'm not using slides today. I don't feel comfortable using slides. I'm using notes, but I'm not showing you slides, because I want you to be present to hear with me. And also, I am going to provide you a worksheet later on. So if you are a learner that needs something to look at and you prefer that, it's coming. But just so you know, I dreamt last night again that I was supposed to be here in feminine, in my feminine power, which means I put on my lipstick again. I put on a skirt. I had pants on earlier. It's very important to me that I live with one of my values, which is intention. And my intention is to show up today living my truth so that I can teach you and set a clear example of what is possible when you listen to the things that we're going to talk about today, which I'll get into. But friends, it wasn't always this easy. I didn't always know about my feminine power. I didn't always know, follow my dreams. It was very different for me growing up in Wisconsin, where in my family, the most important value was a paycheck, safety, stability. I did this for most of my entire career. And not until I started leading a team at Whole Foods, where I got to start hiring people and massage that muscle of hiring and finding people's what lit them up. I moved into tech recruiting, which fired me up so much, but I couldn't coach during tech recruiting as I moved into larger companies, because it actually is not a great idea for the company to have someone coaching on the calls. And so what I'm here to do is I get to feel aligned in coaching. And previously I thought that my value came from what I did, the money I was making, even though I was always making way less money. I think when I first moved to San Francisco, I was making like $35,000. When I think about that, like, my mind is blown. Like, how did I even eat? Well, let me tell you, my husband, who is now my husband, when I first started dating, he helped me pay for food, because food is very important. And so eventually, in a job that I knew I was making below market, I decided to ask for a raise and it was denied. So I decided to leave and got a 40% increase just switching roles. My commute thirded. I had to take Caltrain. It was now a 12 minutes walk. And so now I'm glad that I have been able to build my imposter syndrome muscles. I wish I had asked for the raise earlier, but it's really not until we're ready to do that can we do that. And so, taking a deep breath. My commitment today is, in our 45 minutes together, that I also will strive to be on time. I'm verbose and long-winded, so I'll be keeping an eye on the clock. And I'm going to show you how to finally create a career path with confidence. With our limited time, I wish I could transform your life and give you a pill and just take all the fear and imposter syndrome away, and doubt and your inner critic. And I imagine that if you're here at this summit, I can guess you're a high-achieving person who's read a lot of books, listened to a lot of podcasts, sought mentor after mentor, hoping to find a secret door or shortcut. Unfortunately, there's no shortcut, my friends. The career path is just that, a path. It's a path that we take one step. We take a step, the next decision's available. Take one step, the next decision's available. Your career takes time, just like the phases of our menstrual cycles, the seasons of the year, and the cycles of the moon. They take time, and they are ways to help you harness your power in each phase and season, my friends. So I'm going to give you my best for our time together, and I'm confident that you will find value in what I'm about to share and get exactly what you need right now. But the thing is, I'll need you to show up also, believing that the things I share with you today, even if there's doubt in your mind, inner critic, that's not how you do it, still showing up for that and imagining that you can create the career path that you want. So I'm going to give you my best, and in return, I ask for your best. I ask you right now, as we go through this, to see yourself doing what I show you. Are you ready to move forward with this agreement in place? Don't just nod your head or say it to yourself. I can see you. Remember, I connected to you when we first started. Show for yourself and others around you that can see your power and your energy by adding a yes in the comments right now. Are you ready? Yes, Karen. All right. I'm going to go through the three things you need to have in your career confidence backpack or Lululemon side packet. First, we'll set the context by understanding why you don't feel confident right now in your career path. I love seeing the yeses. I promised you I'd see on time. So, oh my God, I might cry. This waterfall of yeses makes me so happy. You are showing up for yourself. You are showing up for me. You are showing up for all of us. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Oh my God, I have goosebumps. Okay. First, we'll set the context by understanding why you don't feel confident right now. Then I'll give you a path you need to follow. And then we'll talk about your doubt, aka imposter syndrome, that may be running the show, and why that's a good sign. All right, let's begin. Find a comfortable seat, or if you're lying down listening to this, lay down nicely. And if it feels comfortable for you and safe, please close your eyes. I'm going to lead you through a meditation right now, just so you know, so that you feel safe. We're going somewhere to create a vision for you for the future, for your future career path. And I find that if you know where we're going, you're more likely to go. So we're going there. Just begin to notice your breath. Notice if your breath is in your throat or in your heart, or if it's deep down in your torso. Feel into that. No need to change anything about your breath yet. Just notice where it's living. Do you notice any buzzing in your mind? Any thoughts running through like a ticker tape or a terrible playlist that you never wrote or made? Imagine in your mind's eye, redwood's roots growing in your seat, growing down into the floor beneath you, into the earth, down to the center of the earth, and the big fireball that's down there. Connect to the fire below us, and then raise your body like a redwood tree, tall spine, heart up, and reach the crown of your head towards the sky, towards the ceiling of the place that you're in right now, and if you're outside, even effing better. And reach your head to the sky, the stars, the sun, the other fireball above us. Reach the power that you have connected both to your intuition in the sky and the stability that you have created below you. And now bring to mind those fears and doubts and anxiety that you had earlier, perhaps, that we talked about. And just take them and roll them into a tiny little ball and set them next to you on the table. If you want them later, grab them. But for now, we're not interested in them. Thank you for doing your job. See you later. Now take a deep breath and fill yourself up with the heat and the fire from the deep core of the earth and the sun in the sky. Exhale, open mouth. Let it go. Inhale. Open mouth, exhale. Again, last time, inhale together. Open mouth, exhale. And again, bring that vision to your mind's eye. And imagine yourself standing in front of you in a field. Imagine in that field anything you want. Is it grass? Is it flowers? Your favorite flower, my favorite flower is any flowers, actually. I love getting flowers. But specifically, the flower that reminds me of moving here to California is jasmine. So imagine yourself filled with your favorite flower, your favorite plant. Maybe it's full of succulents. And now bring to mind you are looking at yourself. And this is yourself 5, 10, 15, 20 years in the future, 25, 30, 45 years in the future. Where are you living? What are you wearing? What do you do on the weekends? Where do you find joy in your life? Where do you find ease in your life? How do you stay healthy? Where are you working? How are you spending all this delicious wealth that you're making? What's your commute like? What is your family like? What is your family like? How do you spend time with them? Who are you spending time with? What are your friendships like? What are you reading or ingesting for knowledge? Take all this information in, all the details, the color of your pants or skirt or dress, shorts, the shoes that you're wearing, the car that you're driving, the plants around your house, the color of the carpet or hardwood floors, the deliciousness that you realize that you always have running water at your home, the ability to make tea in the morning or coffee, whichever you choose. And really seep these into your bones. This is possible for you. While you're standing there, you notice you have this backpack on your back. It's got joy, it's got courage, and it's got trust in it. Anything you need right now. And as you begin to come to an end of this time with your future self, ask yourself one last time, what message do you have for me that I need to remember? What is something that's important that you need? Thank your future self for this message. Exhale all the way out. Take a deep breath in. Fill all the way up into your torso. let your vision go. Exhale, inhale. Let your vision go on a sigh. Inhale. Let it go. And now begin to twinkle your toes and your fingers. Lick your lips and begin to open your eyes slowly, looking at one thing at a time while you come back to the room. All right, friends. If you got a message that you want to share with the group, please drop it in the comments. And I just got a message from Karen that it takes about 40 seconds. So I'm going to wait. And while we're waiting for those comments, if anyone wants to share what they got and what they're celebrating for their future self, please put it in the comments. And while we're waiting for that, I would love for you to jump in and grab your worksheet, y'all. I'm dropping it in the comments. It's at nicfrick.com/west. And after putting in your email, the link will redirect you to a document. So don't close out after you've done it. I'll be sending this to you later today or tomorrow, by the way. And if you grab this earlier today, you might want to grab it again because I have made some updates after those dreams that I had. All right. All right, my friends. The first thing in your backpack that we talked about is joy. In the book Burnout, Amelia, sisters Nagoski, speak about Kate Mann's description of human giver syndrome in Burnout. In their book, human givers give everything to human beings. One way to move away from human giver syndrome is to follow your joy. They found that when you're doing things that are meaningful and joyful, we actually remain in our bodies. And that is where we keep repeating, What I find is that when we are connected to our human giver syndrome rather than our bodies, we are taking any patterns that we had at a job that we hated before, the trauma, the mental health risk, we're taking them to the next job, regardless of whether or not we want to. So if we're worried about things at work in a previous job, we're likely to bring them to in the same exact way, the self-sabotage that Z talked about in the earlier imposter syndrome workshop, the self-sabotage self-sabotages us over and over and over if we don't create joy in our life. And so this is the practice I always start with my clients, because not focusing on our job, especially when changing jobs, brings those bad habits. And also in following in Big Magic, Elizabeth Gilbert speaks about her book Signature of All Things. And I love this story so much, because when she had finished Eat, Pray, Love and Committed, the two books that she wrote as more autobiographical, she started thinking about writing a book about South America. And she eventually did not. She actually found that someone else wrote that book instead. And while she was having writer's block, she started becoming really interested instead of writing, she started getting very interested in gardening. And so when she would go gardening, she had just gotten a new house. So she was planting plants, learning everything, calling up botanist experts, all of these expert gardeners, so that she could learn everything that she needed to make her own beautiful garden. And little did she know that that seed of those plants planted the ability for her to write a book about Signature of All Things, which is about an expert botanist. And that's one of my favorite parts about where joy starts. It's like following the thread of what's important to you. And if you get nothing else from this today, I need you to start with joy. Joy is how you create the water wings of your career confidence. It's how you spend your time on the weekends. It's how you fill your life up, even when your job gets hard and you hate it and it's dreadful. And when my clients get to work, like start working with me, they like dread going to work. They have the Sunday scaries and they just feel like vessels that aren't any more aware of who they are. And the way that we figure out who we are is by doing things that we love doing. And so if you grab that worksheet, in exercise one, I started your list for you. I would love for you the challenge, and we're gonna not take too much time because I do want to stay in time and I do think you can do this on your own, but I do want to show you that on here, I want you to challenge yourself to list 30 ways you can create joy. Maybe you call it nourishment, maybe you call it peace, maybe you call it freedom or ease in your life that don't involve other people. And this is very important, that don't involve other people. This is how you find value in yourself and not the work that you're doing. And if you're feeling stumped, I've got a few here. Move your body for about 45 seconds to any song. I forgot to put the hyperlink. I'll add that. It's actually at the bottom, but we'll get to that in a second. And then do every day, especially if you're feeling in a rut or you don't know where your career is headed. If you want some, if you want some guidance, start with joy. Start filling up your own cup. Put your own mask on first. Every time that I've had a client recently, actually a client of mine was having extreme imposter syndrome after quitting for 6 years, and she didn't, after quitting her job that was causing her extremely poor mental health, she quit her job, was off for 6 months, and she also doesn't have a degree. So there was a lot of things that she was thinking about because she doesn't have a degree, she wasn't gonna be able to get a job. And lo and behold, the team that she had worked for before, another team reached out to her to ask her for a promotion. She got a 43% pay increase in a job that she was super qualified for. And when she got that, she realized, wow, in my last job, I realized now that I wasn't doing anything that I loved. At the end of the day, I always thought that my value came from the work. And because I found it so boring, it didn't move me. I didn't want to do it. And so I also didn't want to do anything else. And so I forgot who I was. And she started doing and collecting these things. She started reading books for pleasure, taking walks during lunch, spending more time with her husband, going on dates. And it really transformed her life and helps her now have those water wings that she's needed. So go ahead, write down your 30 things. Tell me in the comments if you have any you want to share with us. What I love to see is when people share theirs, because then we can like steal them and make them our own. All right. Anyone got a good one? All right. So remember when I told you that I changed this up a little bit? I wasn't going to do this thing that we're doing until possibly the end if we had enough time, but actually I'm going to try and do it twice instead of zero times. So what I need you to do, please, is this exercise that I do with all of my clients where you'll use this tool. It's on the joy list. It's the first thing on the joy list that I've mentioned there. You'll use this tool called dancing/moving. It's the best way to drop into your body, to get out of your head. If you have a big meeting, like for example, this big meeting I just had where I get to be in front of all of you and connect with all of you, I danced before we started and it got me moving. You can even ask Karen. I was doing it in the backstage so she could see me. And it helps me to be so connected to what I'm up to, and it felt very, very good. And so I want to share with you that practice. Let me know how it feels in your body, okay? So you're not gonna be able to hear me because it cuts me out, but I need you to stand up from your chair, okay? Stand up from your chair and shoot.
You didn't reach your best yet. All right, look. Just in case you ain't got it by now.
Get up from your chair.
Listen to me. Bring it in. If you are alive, I know you ain't reached your best yet. You got more. You could do more. You could see more. You could be more, all right? Right now, you should feel invincible, powerful. Look, where your focus goes, your energy flows. Are you hearing me?
Okay, ladies and gentlemen and people here, I hope that you found some freedom there and that it felt weird and that it felt awesome and it felt all the feelings that you had. They are all awesome and welcome here. No matter how that felt, use that as a way to prepare for a meeting. Like one of my clients, they kept redoing their slides, right? At the 11th hour, all they could think about was their slides. Maybe this was me, but they kept redoing their slides. They kept practicing. And I was like, what you need to do is dance, put on your favorite song. If you can't think of a favorite song, I have a career confidence playlist that you can grab. It's in the bottom of your worksheet. That song, Erica, is called Focus. Energy, rather. It's the first one on the playlist. So I want you to use this before an interview, before a big meeting. Instead of fixing your slides for the billionth time, do this instead. When you're getting in an argument with your kids, when your kids are being annoying and they want to watch Mickey Mouse Clubhouse for the 40 millionth time in the day, play this instead. Get everyone up. It moves us. Like, as you can see, you can probably notice a difference from before and after the song, and you can probably feel a difference in me. I'm like sweating and panting, but I do feel more connected to myself. I hope you notice that. So the second thing in your backpack, first one was joy. Now we're at trust. Trust is the second thing we need in our career confidence backpack. And we build trust with ourselves by living our values. And why this is related to career pathing is when you think about, the career path you've already had, when you look back, everything kind of makes sense, right? You can kind of connect the dots. You can see why you left the last job for the next job and all the things. And so trusting that you always knew what was important before, you can take that information and bring it forward with you. So even though it feels unclear now, trusting that you always will know the way, because you've always already known the way. And Brené Brown defines values as a way of being or believing that we hold most important. And one of the things I love to do is look at our old jobs and see what was important to me when I switched jobs. Was it stability? Was it security? Was it wealth? Was it growth? Was it my development? Was it cool projects? Was it a new type of code that I would get to learn? What were the things that were important as you moved? And then remember that the ways of being turned into our actions that Brené Brown was referring to, our ways of being that we hold most important turn into our actions and then light up the path that we need to be in right now. So your values are that clear path that I was talking about. What lights you up is your career path. Add the joy with your values at every stage of your career, and your values will always be changing. So make sure that you are checking in on your values quarterly, maybe every single time, especially when you feel like a discord with your job. Check in with your values. Like, is one of your values family? Like for me, family is now one of my top values where it never had been. And in a job, if my value is family and being a new mom, that company has to level up or I have to go. And it's totally okay. It's very important to remember that when you join a company, you're joining them at the stage that they're at and the stage that you're at. And sometimes you continue for a long time together, but other times you don't. And that's totally fine. It's totally normal. You're not supposed to remain the same at all. You're not supposed to stay who you are. You're always evolving. Your values are always evolving. You're always shifting in your values. So make sure you're always feeling on track. And when you get to use your values as an anchor, you get to choose the jobs that you want. I have a client who quit her job before having a new job. And then she got a new job that she had interviewed for. They gave her like amazing benefits and compensation. And one of the things that we worked on was that they needed to have, she has a dog that she's so obsessed with. And so she needed an office that was going to allow her to have her dog there. The first day she shows up, they say that we can't have dogs. They said that they could have dogs in the interview, and then it changed. So she immediately, we talked about it. And because she trusts her values and she knows that possibilities are endless and they're available to her, if she can imagine them, she can have them. She quit. A couple weeks later, she found a new job that allowed dogs. Oh, I get goosebumps thinking about her. And one of the ways that I want to work through this workshop is to grab you, to pull you back to this worksheet. So exercise number two, I left that quote there for you, or the description of values that Brené Brown has. And so I'm looking at the time. I think I have until now. So I'm going to go over, Karen. I'm sorry. The value of value. So we're not going to get into this, but just know that if two ways to do this. One way is to take this worksheet and make a list of times when you felt everything in your life was aligned. Coincidences were happening. Things felt easy. You felt in flow. Take stock of those actions and events that happened in the past that felt really aligned that can bring you clarity. And then put those in this box. So how are you feeling? Who are you being? What were you doing? Give all the juicy details to pull out the values that were important to you at that time. For example, one time I felt very aligned was when I was speaking on stage at the Greenhouse Open Conference. It was so aligned for me because it was like, I got to talk about hiring managers. I got to talk about recruiting. I got to travel to New York to do it. I got to be on stage, which is where I love to be. And I just said my values as I said it. But if I were to speak to it as I would write this story, I would say, I stepped on stage with my pal Kevin, who worked at Greenhouse. I was feeling really anxious because when my imposter syndrome shows up, I start freaking out. Even though they had invited me, we had practiced it. I knew it was going to be really good. I had bought a banging outfit. Like, it was going to be amazing. I love being there. And so I wrote, I love being on stage. I loved when people asked questions at the end. They were interested. It felt so aligned for me. So find out what those aligned stories are. And they don't have to be professionally related. Other times when I felt really aligned were when I invite friends to an Airbnb for my birthday and we drink wine and we sleep in and one of them cooks. My favorite food is food made for me. And that is what was happening. And so I want you to find your aligned stories, pull out those values, follow them. And then if you can't think of a value, no pressure, friend. Go ahead and grab the Dare to Lead PDF that Brené Brown has on her website that I've linked here. It's a list of values. You don't have to think about any of them. Just grab hers, pick 10, come up with 10, and then choose 3 that matter to you, okay? And then try these values on. There's instructions here how to try them on. I'm so excited to hear what your values are, y'all. Okay. Any questions? Oh, I love that. Yes. Okay. All right. I'm gonna keep going. All right. The third thing in our backpack, boop, boop, or Lululemon side pocket. Courage is the third and final thing I want you to have in your career confidence backpack. We explore this by validating our imposter syndrome and our inner critic. So that voice that you hear that was like, I can't do that presentation, or I am going to get a bad performance review, or I'm going to get fired, or my inner critic, I call her Ursula, like the sea witch. She likes to say mean things. Her morals are terrible. And so I want to also share with you that when I was creating this workshop, Z mentioned self-sabotage. Every time I overthink something or I'm planning something or excited, I create a migraine. I woke up with a migraine today because I know that if I get a migraine, I don't have to do the thing that I'm afraid to do. I don't have to show up because I have a migraine. That became clear to me once and I was like, oh shit, I'm making this migraine. It's still here a little bit, like ringing in the background, but it's not a real migraine. It's one that I created and manifested because I wanted to make sure that I was being perfect today, that perfectionism creeping in. And despite evidence of speaking on stages and leading workshops that I absolutely love doing, it's my favorite thing, being in groups and using these tools with my clients regularly, I knew when I sat with myself and got quiet, maybe danced, I knew that my knowing, my inner wisdom knew how to show up today. But the slide deck, the rules of how to do a workshop, all the things we've been taught in the patriarchy, like it was telling me how I should do it. And not until I said, look, this is how I'm showing up, did I get to do that. But again, our inner critic, our mind, our negativity, those doubts come from a very, very important place in our mind. It's the low part of our brain, and our lizard brain, and it's there to keep us safe. And when we believe that we don't have a sense of belonging, that we're going to get in trouble from our village, like it wants us to not do those things. So make sure that when you have those inner critic feeling showing up, you just have a conversation with them. Like, what's going on here? What specifically are you telling me right now? Also, what's the worst thing that could happen if your imposter syndrome is true? These are on the worksheet, by the way. What is your imposter syndrome trying to teach you that you can release? And what evidence do you have that counters this voice? Or name three things that you have recently accomplished that you're proud of or have received compliments on. Another tool that my teacher likes to offer is a success altar. And then it's a place where you have somewhere in your house where you have a special place that has pictures of your family, awards that you've gotten. Mine here has the skee ball runner up. There was a team building event that I did once and I got second place. Those are really cool things because I've always been told that I'm not competitive, that I'm not good at activities, that I don't win things. And right there, I have a trophy. So it reminds me that all I do is win, y'all, and so do you. So remember those wins and remember that your brain is trying to help you forget all of your celebrations to keep you safe in your box. But when you start asking for raises, when you start showing up and doing those things that feel in disalignment, I don't want to say hard because I don't want you to do anything that feels hard. I never want you to do anything that feels hard. If it feels hard, it's probably not the right path. Find something else that feels a little bit easy. My teacher, Tara Nicole Kirk, she says, how easy can I let this be? How easy can I let this be? Also, okay, one more thing. I did have this on my notes and I do think it's important related to imposter syndrome is when I was leading the women's organization, the ERG at Cruise called Empowered Women of Cruise, EWOC, I was having a meeting with another leader and she was like, what if imposter syndrome, because we're leading an imposter syndrome workshop. And I said, and she said, what if imposter syndrome isn't imposter syndrome? What if you're just like bad at your job? And I had to take a deep breath because it was very clear that she had internalized the masculinity of that feeling. Like when someone is bad at their job, the most generous thing that we can do, even if it feels scary, is to tell them. Imposter syndrome is something else. It's an internal feeling. It is internal and it's despite evidence that is happening. Imposter syndrome costs us so much. In a study in 2019 of imposter syndrome, it showed that 40% of women in senior positions have consciously not chosen to ask for a pay raise. That's so much money that we leave on the table. Stop doing that. Stop it. Get the support that you need. Get the mentorship that you need. Do the research that you need to feel comfortable. Some of us need to do more research. Some of us are living on the fly, can do that stuff. But when you really do improvise or validate your imposter syndrome, you get to see it in front of you and say, I see you. Thank you. We're not having this conversation anymore, though. You can sit in the back seat. I don't want to play this playlist anymore that I didn't make. I want a sweet playlist that my lover made me, right? I want a mixtape, if you remember mixtapes. Whew, that was a lot. KK, can you tell me how much time we have? I think it's 0 seconds. Okay, yes, literally zero. Okay, that was a lot. That's why you're encouraged to seek out mentorship and a coach. Remember that you can always find career, trust, and joy in your backpack. Make sure that you're creating a board of directors of support. These could be imaginary people, famous people, goddesses that you know. And I think that you can put Barack Obama, Michelle Obama on there, Oprah on there, Lady Gaga, whoever lifts you up and helps you step into that feminine power that you have. And so my wish for you is that you find value in this career path that you're creating. You can't do it wrong. And the reason I call this workshop Three Secrets is because I show up intentionally. One of my values is intentional, and I was intentional about Three Secrets because they are secrets until we remember them and forget them and remember them and forget them. So come back to these tools when you need them. Remember, you're not supposed to do this alone. And I wish you all the abundance, joy, trust, courage, ease, freedom, and blessings that you need on this career journey that I know you're going to be successful at. So thank you so much for having me, West. If we have time for questions, which I don't think we do, please message me. I'm at nic@nicfrick.com, and you can always grab this worksheet. And thank you so much again for being here. The song that we played was the first one on the list. It's called Focus by Disclosure.